Hallelujah. Today we just get into the word. Amen. Hallelujah. And I'm sure this word is going to shift you into the realm of the spirit. Come on, look at your person next to you and tell him this word is going to shift you to the realm of the spirit. Are you ready to get shifted? Are you really ready?
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. I want to take you to the word of God, Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8. It says, there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Can you read with me? Let's all say this. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Are you with me? Can you read along with me out loud? I'm not hearing your voice. There is therefore now to those, everyone say now.
Now.
Say now.
Now.
When it means now, it means now. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's not talking about your past. It's not talking about the future. It's speaking about now. And I'm coming back to this word now. Everyone say loudly now. Hallelujah. Then verse 1 it says who do not walk according to the flesh but according to the spirit. I will explain to you what it means. Amen.
Amen.
So it says there is no condemnation now. Amen. And there's something called as walking in the flesh and walking in the
spirit.
Walking in the flesh and walking in the
spirit.
Amen. For the law of the spirit of life through Christ Jesus, in Christ Jesus, has made me free from the law of sin and death. Amen.
Amen.
For what the law could not do, it was weak through the flesh, God did by sending his own son through the likeness of sinful flesh on account of sin. He condemns sin and flesh. Amen. We won't go through these verses, but I'm going to take you a little ahead. Verse 4. That the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the... Again, it's coming back. Walking not according to the flesh, but walking according to the spirit. I'm going to get back to you what is walking according to the spirit to me is. That the righteous requirement... Verse 4, right? For those who live according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh. Amen. Say minds.
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 But those who live according to the spirit, they set their mind to the things of the... loudly. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Amen. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, nor indeed can be. Ha. Let's stick to this verses. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You know, in these days, I was just doing more study on the book of Revelation. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And I'm still going more deeper, searching for scriptures, studying, going through some notes, this, that. And the whole dilemma that is now going on, if you read the book of Revelation, there are so many point of views. Amen. Are you there with me? There are so many people, I mean, there are thousands of views, and I'm saying, when I say views, I'm saying on the basis of scripture, there are views. Do you understand? So I just put forward, what are the views? There is something called as dispensationalism. there is something called as people believe that in the book of Revelation, people believe we are in the church period. There will be a rapture. Amen. Then there will be tribulation period. Everyone say tribulation period. For 7 years. Amen. After that, there will be millennium. Okay. After that, there will be, what is that? White throne judgment, where Jesus will come back. Amen. And after that, there will be new heaven, new earth. Are you there with me?
Yes.
Hallelujah. So, many people believe in this. Now, some people believe, if you see this, there is something called as rapture. People believe it will come before the tribulation. Some people believe it will come mid-tribulation. Some people believe it will come after the tribulation. Amen. This is a futuristic view. That means they believe in future all these things will happen. Amen. You wondering how I'm moving from Romans to Revelation. Hallelujah. Because I got a revelation. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm excited today. So, are you excited?
Yes.
So this is a futuristic point of view. Amen. Then there is some people who believe in millennium, that is 1,000 years period. Some believe in our millennium. Means people believe that millennium is right now going on. Amen. Amen. Then now there is the preterism. Preterism. Amen. What does preterism says? It says all these things happened in the past. Everyone say past.
Past.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So the preterist will say, all these things happened in the past. Amen.
Amen.
Then there is, some of them don't believe that Jesus will come back again. They don't believe in the rapture. Amen. Now, there is something called as partial preterism. Everyone say partial preterism.
Partial.
They believe that the everything has happened in the past, only Jesus is there to come back in future. Amen. So there are like this many views, and each view a person will support with his scripture. Are you there today?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So I'm looking at all these things now. And I'm saying, God, where do I stand? Where do I put my conclusions? Amen. And it all happened because on Facebook, I put up some post and people were all out. You understand? It's easy to make division. Difficult to do unity. Amen. Hallelujah. So Jesus went and healed a blind person. Do you understand? He just spoke a word, or he touched the eyes and he healed a blind person. And at one instance, the other blind person, he told, put mud in your eyes, or apply mud, wash it, and then you will see. Amen. So the story goes like this. The first blind man who was touched by Jesus and he saw, he came up with a new religion called touchism. And the other blind person who got mud in the eyes and washed, he came with another religion called as mudism. Amen. So the mudism people believe that you should heal only by applying mud. And the touchism people believe that you should be healed only by touching. Ah, hallelujah. So that's what happens now. Amen. That is what is happening to Christianity here. Amen. People are all out to force their views down your throat. Amen. And everyone has, both of them have scriptures to support. Touchism are saying, no, look, Jesus touched. Mudism are people are saying, no, Jesus applied mud. Amen. So that's where we are making fun of Christianity. And all the unbelievers are making fun of us. Amen. Because of disunity. The Bible says above all is love. Where is love gone? Amen. Hallelujah. So I'm sitting here and I'm thinking, there are almost, if you combine all these views, you see, if you believe in the rapture, so some people don't believe in rapture, some people believe in rapture. So you can either fall in rapturism or no rapturism. Amen. If you believe in rapture, some people believe in pre-rapture, pre-tribulation rapture, some believe in post-tribulation. Amen. So now, are you pre-rapturism or post-rapturism? Amen. Do you understand? So, some are mid-rapturism. Amen. My God, so many divisions, you can literally divide yourself. The body of Christ is divided within themselves. Amen. Hallelujah. Some people believe, now it says tribulation is going to be 7 years period, but nowhere in scripture it is mentioned 7 years. So there are seven tribulation whatever, and there are those who say no tribulation whatever. Let me keep these two views. One is past, that it all happened in the past. One is present, that it all happened in present. Sorry, not present. Future, sorry. Future. So one is past, one is future. Amen. Now I have to come up with something new. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you this. The past have people have enough of scripture to prove that the future people are wrong. But the future people have enough of scripture to prove the people who believe in the past are wrong. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Then there are people who believe rapture is right. People who believe rapture is wrong. Fine, it's fine. Amen. Hallelujah. What I'm making a point today is very important. Hallelujah. I am in between these two people. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I go here, he will get angry. I go here, he will get angry. Amen. 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 What I'm saying is, we are looking at time. Everyone say time. We are looking at time. Say time. Some are saying it is past. Time. Someone is saying it's future. Time. Amen. But it says now. Amen. The Bible says now. There is no condemnation. Why there is no condemnation? There is no condemnation if you walk in the spirit and not in the flesh. I want to tell you what is spirit tonight. If you understand what is spirit, you will understand, you will get cleared of all this dilemma. Come on. You need to understand what is spirit. Amen. If you are natural, you are in the flesh. If you are supernatural, you are in the spirit. Are you there?
Yes.
If you're natural, the laws of nature apply to you. But if you're supernatural, the law of nature does not apply to you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. When Jesus set us free, he set us free from the law of sin and death. Hallelujah. He has set us free from the laws of nature. How? If you step into the realm of the spirit, the laws of nature goes away.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are you there with me?
Yes.
The laws of nature go away. Amen. That's why your doctors will say that you are going to die. But if I step into the spirit and I pray over you, you are going to live.
Amen.
The law of the world is saying you are going to die. But the law of the spirit gives you life and peace. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Here where the problem is, why Christians are fighting, why people want to debate with me? Because they are in the flesh. Come on, debate if you are in the flesh. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey, get in the spirit. You'll stop debating, start discussing. And life and peace will come into your life. Right now, you're not in peace. You're not in peace. Hallelujah. You want to disturb everyone's peace because you're in flesh. You need to move in the spirit. How do you go into the spirit? Huh. Look, guys, what is applicable to the flesh? The laws of nature is applicable to the flesh. The laws of sin and death is applicable to the flesh. The moment you step into the spirit, you are supernatural like Jesus. You can go through walls. You can walk on water. If you move in the spirit, you can raise the dead person back to life. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So, the laws of the flesh, I'm going to blow your mind today. Amen. Hallelujah. So, if you say flesh is bound by matter, space, time. My dear Einstein, hallelujah. Do you understand? So, it is, what did Jesus do? When he was on earth, he moved in the spirit. He was a son of man, but he was son of God. He was man and divine. Hallelujah. So he would step in the spirit and he would go through walls. Why? Because he was ruling matter. He would walk on water. Why? Because now he is ruling over matter. He is not connected by matter. Matter cannot touch him, cannot control him. Hallelujah. Space. Amen. He would go against the law of space. How? People would come crowded to hit him and kill him. He would disappear and be found somewhere else. Hallelujah. Time also is a law of flesh. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So, when he said, it is not my time to do this healing, he went, crossed that time, and he did his miracle.
Amen.
He turned the water into wine.
Yes.
Was not his time. But what did he say? Hey, it's not my time, but time is under my control. I am the Lord of time.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Lazarus is dead 4 days. But the time is saying, this is not the time to raise him back. Because he's totally gone in his grave. Jesus comes and says, hey, if you believe, you shall see the glory of God. And so what he does, he changes the time. So, matter is not applicable. Space is not applicable. Time is not applicable. If you are in the spirit. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So the moment you are shifted from the flesh realm to a spirit realm, I want to tell you, nothing is applicable. Time is not applicable. Hallelujah. So the question doesn't arise, hello. If you are in the spirit, question does not arise whether revelation is past or future. For you, revelation can be present. Hallelujah. Oh, are you there? I am not denying, I'm making it clear. I'm not denying rapture. I'm not denying past. Preterist, I'm not denying the futurist. Amen. I need to study and I need to come to a conclusion. But my question is this. Suppose I'm a preterist, how it's going to benefit me and you? Suppose I'm a futurist, how it's going to benefit me and you? I am a spiritist. Hallelujah. If you move into the spirit, there is no time. There is no future, there is no past, it is now. It is now. It is now. Hallelujah. It is now. It is now you can get it. So people who say, oh, there is rapture. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's going to be before the tribulation, after the tribulation. How does it matter to me? I believe that I can get raptured right now when I'm praying to the Lord. I can get into the spirit, have one-to-one connection with the Lord, meet the Lord Jesus when I'm praying. Yes. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
People say, hey, you'll get raptured one day. Fine, maybe you're right. I'm not saying you're wrong. Amen. One day everyone will get raptured and we will meet God, Jesus in the air. Amen. But if you get into the spirit, you can get raptured right now and have your relationship with Jesus in the air, in the water, in the earth above, in the heaven, anywhere. Hallelujah. Now that is beneficial. Come on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise
now Bob Jones was one of the father of the prophets in America. The Western prophets. Amen. He died. He said, I get raptured every day. Amen. He said, I get raptured every day. What does he mean? That means every time he sits and he prays, he's in the spirit with the Lord. He's with the Lord. He's with the Lord Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So, you know, I was sitting and thinking, hey, what should I do? Amen. The futurist people are saying, you will be glorified when Christ returns. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Christ will return. Christ will come again. True. Amen. I'm not denying. What I'm saying, how does it matter if it's going to happen 1,000, 2,000 years after? My Bible says, Romans chapter 8. Let's go there. Ah, Jesus. Today I'm telling you, there's going to be manifestation of the Spirit in this place. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Romans chapter 8, verse 20 now. For whom he foreknew, he predestined to be conformed to the image of his son. He might be blah, 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 blah. Whom he called, these also justified. And whom he justified, he also glorified. Past tense. Amen. Hallelujah. So it's, I saw. My Bible is saying I'm already glorified. Amen. The futurists are telling me one day you will get glorified. Fine, brother. You are right. Amen. I am not denying it. But I am saying the past people will say you are already glorified. The preterist will say, you're already glorified. The futurist will say, you will be glorified when Christ returns. Amen. I'm not denying both of them. What I'm saying is, if I move and walk in the Spirit, I am going to be glorified now. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm going to walk in the glorified nature and the image of Jesus Christ. Are you there?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Are you understanding what is happening? The past, the preterist people will say the temple was destroyed in 70 AD. Amen. The futurist will say the temple is destroyed, but it's going to be built in the future, the Jerusalem temple. But if you walk according to the Spirit, you are the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. The past, the time is, and the future time is no longer applicable to you. You can be in the past, present, future if you walk in the Spirit, and everything is applicable to you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Are you seeing this?
Yes.
Are you seeing this?
Yes.
I want to tell you something. All the saints of the Old Testament, why were they getting blessed? Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, all these people. Why were they getting blessed? Because they believed they were the shadow of the new covenant. Am I there? Are you there? They were shadow of the new covenant. That means though they were in the past, they had their faith set on the future. Agreed? But my thing is that it's not that they had their faith in the future. That means though they were in the past, they believed in the death of Jesus in the future. But that's not the truth. It's partly the truth. They jumped into the Spirit, and for them it was now. They went out of the dimension of time. Therefore, they were more blessed. Today, if you and I are going to fight about the past, revelation is whether it happened in the past or the future, we are going to miss the mark. What I'm saying, come on, get into the Spirit and taste it now.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey, you are glorified. Walk in the Spirit and you will walk in the glory. Hey, you were justified, that's why you're glorified. Amen. Hey, you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Walk in the Spirit, you will become the temple of the Holy Spirit. But if your mind is set on the flesh, you're going to miss it out. If your mind is set on the flesh, you are going to keep on arguing whether it was past and or the future. You're going to miss the Spirit. Ah,
yes.
Are you there?
Yes.
Are you there?
Yes.
So, if you're going to argue, you're going to allow time to control you.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can I tell you, one person who went through the whole revelation experience, do you understand? There was one person who went through the whole revelation experience, whole book of revelation experience. For him, it was neither the past, it was neither the future. You know who it is? John. John experienced the whole revelation experience in his visions, in his spirit. In the Lord, John says, in the Lord's day, I was in the Spirit. That's why he experienced the whole book of Revelation, because he was in the Spirit. If you are in the Spirit, you can be the temple of the Holy Spirit. You can be glorified. You can be raptured now in the Spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh, that's amazing, guys. Are you understanding?
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Are you understanding?
Yes.
John says, I heard a noise saying, come up here. And he went up. And he had the whole book of Revelation. Hallelujah. What he was doing, he was sitting outside the time dimension and seeing the whole thing. Because he was in the spirit. He got raptured. He went up, come up here. And he saw the whole thing in the spirit. Hallelujah. Because he was walking in the spirit. He was caught up in the Lord's day. Guys, I want to tell you, you can be the next John. I can be next John. God is waiting to show you the whole revelation. That's why it says, blessed is the one who reads, blessed is the one who hears, blessed is the one who understands the book of Revelation. Why? Because as you are coming out of time and moving in the spirit, you can experience the whole book of Revelation. I'm not denying the future. I'm not denying the past. What I'm saying is, come on, get into the spirit and experience everything all together. It's not about time. Time is not controlling you. You are controlling time. Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
What's the debate about? What's the debate about? The future is, people will say, hey, there will be the new earth, new heaven, and a heavenly Jerusalem coming down on earth. Amen. And you will be inside that heavenly Jerusalem. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Bible says, Hebrews chapter 12 verse 22. Hebrews chapter 12 verse 22. I'm thinking, God, Jesus, can somebody, Hebrews chapter 12 verse 22. But you are come to
Mount Zion.
You are come to
Mount Zion. And to the
city of the
living God.
Then
the
which Jerusalem?
Jerusalem.
It's saying, hey, hello. It's saying the futurist are saying, hey, there's going to be Jerusalem coming down. I'm not denying it. It's for you. It will happen for you. Amen. As long as you're in the flesh, it will happen. Amen. But I prefer to be in the spirit. I prefer not to be in the future, not to be past. I prefer to be now. Now in the spirit. And therefore, there is no condemnation. Please don't condemn me. Hello, people watching me on Facebook, please don't condemn me. Therefore, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not according to the flesh, but I am walking according to the Spirit. Hallelujah.
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 Woo. The New Jerusalem. Hey. If I'm going to wait for the New Jerusalem, it's long time, yeah. If you want, you can wait. I'm not saying it will not happen. Might happen. You wait for it. But what I'm saying is, if you walk in the Spirit, you can experience it right now. Right now. The new city, Jerusalem. The Mount Zion. Imagine. You experience it right now. Imagine you get raptured every day of your life into the realm of the Spirit. Meet Jesus face to face. Talk to Him face to face. Why are you waiting? Oh, 2,000 years, 3,000 years, He will come. Experience Him right now. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Oh, when the Jerusalem temple will be rebuilt. Oh, it was broken in the past. The past person is pulling you. The future person is pulling you. The time is controlling you. Hey, I'm not in control of time anymore. I'm controlling the time now. I am the now in the spirit. Bring it on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says in the book of Ephesians, you are seated in heaven in Christ Jesus. Where are you? If you are in the flesh, you are on the chair. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If you are in the spirit, you are in heaven. But it's not only your spirit that is in heaven. If you set your mind in the spirit, you wholly are in heaven. You didn't get me. Didn't catch it. Hallelujah. So people will argue, no, the spirit is in heaven, the body is on earth. No. If your mind is on things of the spirit, your whole being is in heaven. Are you there? Are you there? What is the argument all about? How are you who believe in the future going to benefit me? Or you who believe in the past going to benefit me? I am reliving my life now. Are you there with me? I want to live my life now. In the realm of the spirit. So I walk in the realm of the spirit. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's time for the church of God to start walking in the spirit and meeting Jesus face to face and having rapture every day. It's time for the children of God to start walking in the new Jerusalem, in the new heaven and the new earth. Hallelujah. It's time, guys. It's time for you and for me. You know why it is time? Because time is not controlling you. You are controlling. You see, Jesus says it's not my time to do this miracle. Hallelujah. We all are saying it's not the time for rapture now. It's going to happen in the future. Hallelujah. It's not the time for tribulation now. It's going to happen in the future. It's not the time for the new heaven and new earth to come. It's going to happen in future. Maybe for you. Correct. No arguments. But Jesus is saying, now I'm going to walk in the spirit. And though it is not my time, I'm going to take control of the time and still turn the water into wine for everybody. So you know, though it is not the time for the rapture, though it's not the time for tribulation, though it's not the time for new heaven and new earth, it is time for you. If you walk in the spirit, you can make it right now yours. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So everyone is arguing, will the Christian go through tribulation? Hallelujah. Will there be a millennial kingdom? I'm telling you, everyone who lived on this earth, supernaturally, they went through the tribulation unharmed. Hallelujah. Why did Elijah got raptured? Why Enoch got raptured? Because they were walking in the spirit. Unlike us who are fighting when we are going to walk, when we are going to go away. You didn't get this. Why was Elijah able to be raptured? He went boom. Enoch went. Bible says, Enoch would walk with God.
Yes.
We are called to walk in the spirit. If you walk in the spirit, you can experience the whole book of Revelation. If it is past, you can experience it now. If it is future, you can experience it is now. I am not denying the past. I am not denying the preterist. I am not denying the futurist. What I am saying, if you walk in the spirit, come on, stand up and walk now.
Amen.
I think I deserve a big round of applause. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. People just want to argue. Why? Because you're looking at the flesh. That's why you want to argue, you want to debate, you want to fight, you want to tell people that you are, what you are saying is right. Amen. I'm not denying you are right. In your place, you are right. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. In your place, you are right. Preterists want to say, hey, this is, in your place, you are right, preterist. In your place, you are right, futurist. But if you move in the spirit, I am right. Hallelujah. We are all right. Amen. Hallelujah. If you get into the spirit, we are all right. We are all right. We are all right. Amen. Hallelujah. And it's all right. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, it's all right. Chill. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, you know, I was asking this question. My phone is here. Today morning, I'm sitting and asking this question. Jesus, God, in his scripture, it is said, I'm glorified. I am the temple of the Holy Spirit. I am the body of Christ. And we are, and I am, what is that? I am already into the new city, Jerusalem. Then it says, I am the city set on a hill. Hello. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So I'm wondering, God, are the preterists right or the futurists right? Who is right? The Lord says, if you are in the spirit, all of this you are. You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. You are a son of God. The whole creation waits for the manifested. The problem here is, we all are telling people something is going to happen, and all of us are holding our hands and waiting for that something to happen. My thing is, you can experience that something now. Why don't you experience it? Hallelujah. And when it happens, also experience it. Who cares? But you can experience it right now. Hallelujah. John experienced the whole book of Revelation, the tribulation, the trumpets, and everything. Amen. Why don't you experience the same thing? If you are in the spirit, you can. Yes. Hallelujah. You can do your rapture pre-tribulation, post-tribulation, mid-tribulation, post-millennium. Do wherever you want. You can do it now. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you tell somebody, hey, the rapture is there, you will not sit and pray and meet the Lord. If I'm going to tell you, we are all going to meet the Lord in the air in the future, honestly, I'm not sure whether it's going to happen or I'm not going to say anything. I've not done my studies completely in this. But I'm talking about walking in the Spirit. If you walk in the Spirit, you can experience those things now. Now. Do you understand? God is not bound by time. 1,000 years is one day for God. Do you understand? When you're watching a movie, have you watched a movie in your life? In a movie you see, a child is growing and then he becomes old and he dies. How long do you see it? In 3 hours, the person is grown and become old and died. God is outside the time. So for him, 1,000 years is just like one day. Hallelujah. Do you understand? Why? Because he's outside that dimension of time. He's in the spirit. When you're in the spirit, you're outside the dimension of time. Do you understand what is time? Are we going to live in the dimension of time, or are we going to control the time in our life? We believe in supernatural miracles. Are you there?
Yes.
We believe Jesus turned the fish and bread into, he multiplied. We turned the water into wine. Why? Because he could control matter. We believe he controlled space. We believe he controlled time. Amen. Hallelujah. If you believe, that means you are not in control of time, matter, and space. You are controlling time, matter, and space. It's time for the church of God to rise up and the sons of God to rise up and manifest their sonship.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
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 Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
We are called manifest sons of God. Why? Because the whole creation is waiting. When are you going to manifest yourself? When are you going to manifest yourself? Hallelujah. When are you going to manifest yourself? Are you going to stick and argue about past and the future? Or are you going to manifest as a son of the living God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So I want to tell you, say, I am the temple of the Holy Spirit.
I am the temple of the Holy Spirit.
Honestly, I'm not interested about the future temple going to be built in Jerusalem or no. Amen. How is it going to benefit me? I don't know. But if I am the temple of the Holy Spirit, it surely does benefit me in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Say, you are the body of Christ. Look at your body and say, this is the body of Christ. We are the body of Christ.
We are the body of
Christ. Jesus might come 2000 or how many years back he came, but he might come again. As a whole body, amen. But right now, I want to manifest as the body of Christ on earth. Hallelujah. You and I need to manifest as the body of Christ. Hallelujah. And the body of Christ is not divided. Are you there? The body of Christ is not divided. Today, everyone wants to speak about all these things. Amen. You understand? Divided, division. Amen. Hello? How will Christ come again if you are going to be divided? My question is that. Amen. You're going to argue about everything. Pre-tribulation, post-tribulation, mid-tribulation. Your life only is tribulation. With this argument. Hallelujah. Do you understand? That rapture has ruptured your brain. When will that rapture happen? Come on, you are right, I am wrong, this is right. Hey, it's ruptured your brain. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can somebody say, forget about all this, let's move in the spirit. And in the spirit, there is no time. In the spirit, there is no time. Let's walk in the spirit, and in the spirit, there is no time. I am the body of Christ. I am already into the new Jerusalem, the heavenly Jerusalem. Wow, look at that. I just love that. This is like, I love that. I've fallen in love with that. Can you read that? Hebrews chapter 12, verse 22. I just love that verse. It's so powerful. Amen. Do you understand? Instead of telling people, hey, one day, amen. Everyone say, one day, you will go to heaven. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You have come. Everyone say, I have. I have. When? 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 Say, I have come now to Mount Zion. Do you understand? It's not saying take a flight ticket. Let's have a pilgrimage to Jerusalem. Paular Paul Marun Tin Soluya Devakandosh Jerusalem. Yeah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Do you understand? Hey to Jerusalem Paulo. It's saying you are now. Amen. Now you are in Mount Zion. Then what it says? And you are now to the city of the living. Hey, did you didn't hear the verse. It says you are in the city of the living God. Right now, are we in the city of the? No. Because why we can't see it? If you are in the flesh, you can't see it. But if you start moving into the spirit, you are in the city. You will start seeing angels. You will start seeing the saints. You will start seeing God. If you move in the spirit, walk in the spirit. The thing is, we want to get into the flesh. And when we get into the flesh, we are bound by time, space, and matter. Because we are bound by time, space, and matter, then we say, we will go to heaven. The kingdom of God is come, guys. And Jesus says, it is in you. Hello? Ah. Passion Translation. People have problem with that guy. Forgive that God. Protect him. Hallelujah. He's saying we have already come. Isn't it beautiful? Can you open your eyes in the realm of the spirit and look how beautiful is the Mount Zion, the heavenly Jerusalem, in the city that which you have already come now. I'm telling you, it's beautiful. You will experience the presence of God if you really believe this. Walk in the Spirit. How do you walk in the Spirit? By faith. Everyone say, by faith.
By faith.
Believe by faith. Get into it and you will see the saints. Hallelujah. The angels. Jesus himself. You believe in rapture? Very good. Hallelujah. God bless you. Get raptured. When you get raptured, remember me. I'll also come with you. I have no problem. But right now, why don't we experience it? Right now, why don't you experience it? Now. Everyone say now.
Now.
Can you read it? Read the whole verse. I love that verse. No. Passion. Hallelujah. We have come in different realm. Everyone say with me, please. As you say this, God's realm will manifest in your life.
Amen.
Say as if you believe. So say, in contrast, we have come into a different realm. Not the flesh realm, but in the spirit realm. Then,
for we have entered the city of the living God.
Of the living God. Come on. Say, we have entered.
We have entered.
Say, I have entered.
I have entered.
I have entered.
I have entered.
The city of the living God.
The city of the living God.
No, brother, I have to die and then only I can enter. Hallelujah. And some people, no, I first need to go, you know, when I went to Korea, I had to go to Bangkok, and from Bangkok, I had to go to Korea. So some people, First, I have to go to purgatory. From purgatory, I will be shifted into heaven. Amen. Fine, go ahead. Hallelujah. But it says, now, please read this, madam. We have entered the city of the living God, which is the new
Jerusalem.
Which is what?
New
no, not just Jerusalem. Which is what?
New Jerusalem.
In Revelation chapter 21, which Jerusalem is coming?
Jerusalem.
And which Jerusalem are you entering? Hallelujah. I'm not denying there won't be new Jerusalem, new earth. Maybe for you it is. I agree with you 100%. See you there. But guess what? I'm going to be there first. Hallelujah. I'm going to be there first because I'm already there. See you. Hallelujah. See you in the new Jerusalem. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The only thing is you are defined by time. My journey is not defined by time. Hallelujah. Your journey is defined by time because your mind is carnal and you are thinking about the flesh, how it can go. But I'm in the spirit. See you. Look at your neighbor and see you. Say.
See you.
See you later, alligator. Hallelujah. See you later, alligator, in New Jerusalem. Alligator. Amen. Then what it says?
In heaven.
We have joined festal gathering with myriads of angels in a joyous celebration. Across the bridge, there's no more sorrow. Across the bridge, there is no more pain. That time will come. You heard that song? We will go there. You go there across the bridge. I'm already there across the bridge. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm already across the bridge. How about you? Hallelujah. Hey, if you walk in the spirit, you're already in the new Jerusalem. Woo! Hallelujah. You're already in the new Jerusalem. You're already in the new city, Jerusalem. Hallelujah. If you are in the spirit. If you're walking in the spirit, for you it is future, or for you it might be past. For me in the spirit, there's no time. It is now. Hello? Solves the matter. No more arguments. Hallelujah. Solves the matter. Amen. Hallelujah. Do you understand? Jesus died 2,000 years ago. But if you are in the spirit, he has died for you now. There's no time. His blood is still applicable to you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
His forgiveness is still applicable to you. You are under the finished work of the cross. You can't say, oh, it's a past thing. Amen. It's not past. It is now if you are in the spirit. In the realm of the spirit, everything is now. You can move in the time if you are in the spirit. You can go back to Genesis if you are in the spirit. You can go to the book of Revelation if you are in the spirit. You can go to Abraham if you are in the spirit. No time. I'm just watching a movie. Hello. Hello. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Do you understand? Such things don't make you cult. It's the word of God. It rather makes you more to keep your faith, believe, and walk in the Spirit. Can I tell you, Jesus loves you so much that now you can experience His heaven. You can experience the thousands of angels. You can experience the joyous celebration now. That's why we see gold dust, gemstones here, now. Why? Because in spirit, we are in heaven. And the heaven starts manifesting on earth. Do you understand? The heaven starts manifesting on earth. The heaven starts manifesting on earth when you start walking in the Spirit. Come on, you're just so quiet. I feel like, go home. Hallelujah. Go away. Hallelujah. I'm so excited today. Hallelujah. Now, I made notes today this morning. How is it? I want to tell you, if you look at your body and say, I am glorified. I am the body of Christ. And if you believe and walk in the Spirit, believing this, your sicknesses will go away. Amen. If you say, I am the temple of the Holy Spirit, I'm telling you, sickness and weakness is going to go away. And you will start seeing gold dust, silver dust, every dust. You start seeing heavenly dust and earthly dust will go away. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You see, the Bible says, by His wounds and by His stripes, we are past tense. Amen. But it becomes now for you when you are in the Spirit. Are you understanding? So, when does a person get healed with that scripture? When he takes the scripture and gets into the Spirit and walks in the Spirit, that scripture is now applicable to you. You are now healed by His stripes, by His wounds. What happened 2,000 years ago is now happening to you because now you are in the Spirit. Now you are at the foot of the cross and Jesus has died for you and given His life for you. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo! Make some noise here, stupid people. Hallelujah. 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 You see, every time, John is a wonderful guy, amen. What an apostle. What people experienced in the past or people would experience in the future maybe, John experienced when he was in prayer in the Spirit. Hallelujah. He went through the rapture. He went through the tribulation. He went through the Antichrist. He went to all those things. And he said, hey, see, I have written the whole book of Revelation. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He saw Jesus face to face. Why? He was in the Spirit. He was in the Spirit. He was walking in the Spirit. Say, I am going to walk in the Spirit. And the laws of sin and death is not going to be applicable to me. Time, space, and matter is not going to control me. You know, we talk about, the Bible says, the church, the apostles, the prophets, and who evangelists are given to the church for the edification of the church. Till the fullness, what is that? To bring the church to the fullness of Christ. What does bringing the church to the fullness of Christ means? What does bringing the church to the fullness of Christ means? Means Now you are healing a leg. A day will come, you will raise the dead people just like that. Amen. That's the fullness of Christ. And when you have raised the dead, he won't die again. That's fullness of Christ. Hello? Yes. Now you are praying and getting gold dust. What is fullness of Christ? One day the whole box of gold biscuits are going to fall. That's fullness of Christ. Hallelujah. So long you were quiet, now woo! Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. What is fullness of Christ? This is the fullness of Christ. Why are we limiting God to this small thing? Hello? Hello? This is the fullness of Christ. We are all need to come to the fullness of Christ, and that will not happen till we start all walking in unity in the Spirit. Hallelujah. That's when we start experiencing the fullness of Christ. Now you see, there are so many testimonies. I heard people having supernatural travel. Suddenly they are in China, or suddenly they go in America. Amen. Hallelujah. But it's happening once in a while. Do you understand? What is fullness of Christ? Every day you go to America without visa, passport, to UK, you preach the gospel, come back again. This is fullness of Christ, that it happens every day in your life. Why? Because when you are in the fullness of Christ, time, space, and matter will not matter. Amen. Did you understand? Time, space, and matter will never matter to you. That's called fullness of Christ. Amen. Hallelujah.
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 So stop arguing. Stop debating. Just walk in the Spirit and go somewhere. Walk, 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 and go somewhere. Hallelujah. Stop debating, stop arguing, walk in the Spirit, walk so much that you just go somewhere, don't bother anybody. Hallelujah. Don't bother anyone. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The thing is, you want to remain in the flesh and eat everyone's brains. Just be in the Spirit. Walk, 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 and go somewhere far away. You are at peace, I'm also at peace. Hallelujah. So those who walk in the Spirit and set their mind on the spiritual thing, for them it is life and peace. So all you guys who are not in peace, peace be with you, and may the Lord bless you. Let's all stand up and let's pray. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Are we ready to walk? A time will come that we will not fall sick, because we are walking in the fullness of Christ. Hallelujah. Our walk with Christ has become so good that now we are walking in Spirit and walking in the fullness of Christ. A time will come where people are not going to die, guys. We need to come to that place. We need to come to that point of fullness of God. And if we don't preach it, we will not achieve it. We will all wait that something in the future is going to take place. Or we will believe in the past it all took place. So in present, we eat, sleep, and do what we want. Hallelujah. No, God in present wants you to manifest yourself as sons of God. Walk in the Spirit in the fullness of Christ.